I'd like to call to order the Wyoming City Council meeting for Monday, May 20, 2024. First item of business is the invocation by Pastor Matt Yonker from Resurrection Life Church. If you wish and are able, please stand for the invocation. The Pledge of Allegiance will immediately follow.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we just thank you for today, another day that you've given us to govern and be a part of the governing of the city of Wyoming. Father, I pray that you be with this city. I pray that you be with its leaders before me. Father, I pray that you give them wisdom as they make the decisions that affect the people of this community. And Father, we just pray for the community as well. Father, I pray that they are blessed and that they will flourish in every part of their life. Father, we pray for our officers and our firemen and women and first responders. Father, keep them safe as they go out and do their job every day. Father, bring them home to their families every evening and every morning. And Father, we just thank you for the work that they do, keeping us safe and keeping us protected. And Father, we also pray as we come upon a week from today, Memorial Day, Father, we just lift up our servicemen and women that have served our nation, that have provided us the freedom to govern in the way that we govern. Father, may we never forget the sacrifices that they have made and their families have made. And Father, we just pray that you bless them, Father, and pray that you bless this evening. Pray that you would give wisdom to our leaders as they make decisions to affect our community. In Jesus' name, amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Let's do a roll call.
Councilmember Arnoyes.
Here.
Brand.
Present.
DeKreiger.
Here.
Hill.
Here.
Postma.
Here.
Postler.
Here.
Mayor.
Here. Student recognition. If we have any students in the audience tonight that would like to come up and introduce themselves, if you're here for class credit or just to learn more about how Wyoming operates as a city, come on up and give us your name and what school you attend. Okay, seeing none, we'll take approval of minutes from May 6, 2024 and the May 13, 2024 work session. Unless there are items that need to be looked at or changed or discussed, those will stand as presented. You all received those. Any concerns or questions? Okay, minutes approved. Approval of agenda, Mr. Shea?
No changes.
Okay, take a motion to approve the agenda. Motion by DeKreiger, support by Postma. Let's call the roll.
Councilmember DeKreiger.
Yes.
Postma.
Yes.
Arnoyes.
Yes.
Brand.
Yes.
Hill.
Yes.
Postler.
Yes.
Mayor.
Yes. Public hearings. We have none tonight. We'll go to public comment on agenda items. The public comment period is reserved for comment on agenda items only. If you wish to speak about an item that is not on the agenda, please hold your comments until the acknowledgement of visitors at the end of the meeting. It is important to note, this is not an opportunity for dialogue or debate. This is an opportunity to provide comment to the City Council. Upon approaching the podium, please begin by providing your name and address. There's a 3-minute limit per person. Anyone here like to address any agenda item tonight?
Hi, Aiden Wysocki at 4422 Hyde Park Avenue. I don't remember the agenda item number, but it's the one for the Downtown Development Authority budget approval. And I just wanted to get some more information about what is what are the costs going forward for the $300,000 that are proposed in the 2024-2025 fiscal budget. Last year it was only $47,000 used in the budget, even though it was proposed $200,000 to be used. Perhaps there was just something that the money just wasn't spent on that was being planned. I just want to see like why we didn't use the full budget last year.
Thank you. We can cover that when the motion comes up, right? Thank you. Anyone else? Okay, seeing none. Presentations and proclamations, we have none. Petitions and communications, we have none. Reports from city officers. 12B, please.
City manager report 24-12, acceptance of city center sanitary sewer easements.
Mr. Shea?
So as
I'll get a motion. Motion, please. Motion by Hill, support by Postman. Postman.
So as the council's aware, we're installing sanitary sewer on Hook Avenue. When they started digging, they saw that the gas main was a little bit located a little bit further to the east than what it was marked on the plans. So the sanitary sewer had to be moved a little bit further to the east, and that required easements from the property owners on the east side of Hook Avenue. And so that's what these easements are for.
Any questions for Mr. Shea on that? Mr.
That,
Brand?
Not a question. Were they hard to get, those easements? Are they pretty easy to get, those easements?
Yeah.
Were they? Okay. I just wonder how. I just don't know if somebody approached me how I would take that. I'm just curious how our citizens take those.
Probably everyone's on a case-by-case basis, but yeah. In this particular case, we were able to get all of the easements that we needed to get.
Good.
When you get to like the third transmission main, sometimes there's negotiating back and forth over to the, what they feel the value of that easement is. But here we were able to get those.
That's good. Thanks. Thanks, citizens.
Any more questions? Call the roll.
Councilmember Hill?
Yes.
Postma?
Yes.
Arnoyes?
Yes.
Brand?
Yes.
DeKreiger?
Yes.
Hostler?
Yes.
Mayor?
Yes. Budget Amendment A, please.
Budget Amendment number 51 is to appropriate an additional $150,000 of budgetary authority to provide the necessary funds for the acquisition of easements and legal fees associated with construction of the third water transmission main.
Motion, please. Motion by Postler, support by Postma. Mr. Shea.
So this will be related to item 16I on the agenda, where you'll see that there are a bunch of easements that we're still acquiring for the third transmission main. And these easements include not only the easements, but settlement for crop damage as a result of the main that will be going through those people's properties.
Any questions? I know I talked to Mr. Shea the other day, and he said we're coming near the end, of at least for phase one, right, Scott?
We are.
We are. Arnoyes. Oh, do you want to say something, Scott?
No, go ahead.
Just a question on, as we look at the aggregate costs of all this to be able to implement and then passing this on to buyers of our water, will this be included in the calculation of the overall cost to deliver service?
It'll be included in the calculation of the overall cost of the third transmission main project. And given the size of that project, while these easements aren't cheap, it's not a huge amount of the project budget overall.
Right. I understood. I just want to make sure that's still part of that calculation.
Yes.
Even though it's a nominal amount in regard to the overall scope of it.
It is.
Okay. Thank you.
How are we fitting within our budget of easements?
How are we doing? Is that what you asked?
Yes.
Doing fine. So this budget amendment that you're voting on here will give us sufficient funds to pay for the easement that's in front of you tonight and two remaining easements we have yet to secure, which aren't going to be very expensive at all, and some anticipated legal fees and expenses from working with outside counsel to obtain these.
And I'm assuming we have the funds to cover these, so this isn't even borrowed funds.
That's correct.
That's awesome. Thank you.
Oh, it's not going to be part of the bond issuing and all that?
Actually, we will reimburse ourselves right. with bond proceeds for all costs associated going back some period of time. I don't remember the period of time. I think maybe it's 18 months, Mr. City Attorney, some period of time.
It was a long time ago.
We can go back and we can say we consulted with Prine and Newhoff, and we had easement acquisition costs and those costs, and we will basically reimburse ourselves with bond proceeds.
Okay, great. Thank you.
Any more questions from this side? None? Call the roll.
Councilmember Postler?
Yes.
Postma?
Yes.
Arnoyes?
Yes.
Brand?
Yes.
DeKreiger?
Yes.
Hill?
Yes.
Mayor?
Yes. Consent agenda, please. Oh, we don't need to read that.
We
just
don't
need a motion.
Need
motion to approve. DeKreiger, support by Postler. Just like to again mention that Oftentimes, we give appreciation to individuals who have served as members of one of our committees or boards, and this includes a couple of those folks tonight. So thank you for your service. Let's call the roll.
Councilmember DeKreiger?
Yes.
Hostler?
Yes.
Arnoyes?
Yes.
Brand?
Yes.
Hill?
Yes.
Postema?
Yes.
Mayor?
Yes. Resolutions. We're going to take D, C, D, E, F, G, and H together, and then we will discuss each, and then so we'll have opportunity, but we're going to take them together as one motion. Strano.
I make that motion.
He moves. DeKreiger seconds. Thought you were asking a question.
I just am a little confused on that.
We're taking my motion and a support to take all five of these budget resolutions. We'll discuss each one individually, and at that point, if you have questions or concerns or whatever, we can deal with that at the time.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Yeah.
Do you want me to read those?
Yes.
Okay. So Resolution D is adopting fiscal year 2024-25 Wyoming City budget and property tax levy to be known as the City's 2024-25 General Appropriations Act. Resolution E is to amend a portion of the City of Wyoming fee schedule. Resolution F is to approve the Grand Valley Regional Biosolids Authority fiscal year 2025 budget. Resolution G is to approve the 2024 through 2029 capital improvement plan. And Resolution H is to approve the 2024-2025 budget for the Wyoming Downtown Development Authority.
So, Mr. Shea, why don't you walk us through each of those? When we get to E on the fee schedule, is that when we'll mention the revised memo we got tonight?
Yeah, so just, D is the budget that we've been talking about since March. So,
correct.
And Jody gave a really good presentation of that at the last work session meeting, maybe it was.
Yeah.
So if there are any questions on that, because I know we've been through that quite a few times. The fee schedule is what we've discussed also at the March work session. There was just one error on that, so we did correct the error on that to reflect what we presented in March. So
that's in front of everybody.
Yep. The Biosolids Authority, so the City of Wyoming and the City of Grand Rapids are a member of the Grand Valley Regional Biosolids Authority, and this is the authority that we use in terms of the treatment and disposal of biosolids. And they have about a $12.5 million total budget. Wyoming's share is about $5.5 million of that, and it's actually this year's share is slightly less than last year's share. And they base that on the previous year's final processed amount of biosolids. So there's a pretty intense calculation that goes into that. But suffice it to say that our share will be just slightly less next year than it was this year. And we pay for that share out of our sewer fund. We have the capital improvement, the five-year capital improvement plan that we've also discussed at previous work sessions. And then the 2024-2025 DDA budget. We are starting to see more revenue come in on the DDA side than has been in the past, because the taxable value in the district is going up with some of the development that's been going on. And I know, I think Nicole mentioned to me that the some of the numbers here represent historical averages of what we've spent before, but the DDA board is going to be looking in terms of what improvements it wants to make within the DDA district. So for example, I don't want to get ahead of the DDA, but I believe the street lights that are on 28th Street within the district are owned by the DDA, and is that something that they may look at wanting to replace as well?
So it has some
repairs to irrigation, landscaping repairs, any other type of things like that.
Tommy, I know you had a question on the DDA budget, and then I want to make sure if we can, we address the residents' question about why it's more this year than last year. Maybe you can do that, Nicole.
Well, the question that I heard was, what are the funds being spent for on the DDA this year? And City Manager Shea went through most of those. I will note one item, that there's one item that we're reappropriating from this current fiscal year to next fiscal year, and that's for City Center,
Project Cost City Center.
Thank you, Project Cost City Center. And the intent there last year, we had that approved through council and through the DDA, and it was as the bridge goes into place, it's the landscaping along the Crescent Street. Because the bridge has been delayed, we're reappropriating those funds to next year. So we're showing that on the schedule. So that's a good portion of next year's DDA budget. Most of the remaining funds are historical averages. It's the average maintenance landscaping costs that we have that we just kind of year on year carry through. As City Manager Shea had suggested, we are having larger conversations with the board about what to do with the fund balances as we continue to see higher capture rates. And one of those conversations specifically has been about the lighting along 28th Street. Many of those lights are in poor condition. We can no longer find parts to replace them. So that's not part of this year's budget cycle or conversation. We would look at it for the next fiscal year.
Okay. Commissioner Brand, did you have a question about?
Well, just that the DDA, like the lawn maintenance for $40,000, that would, if they didn't have DDA, that would have to be taken care of by the City of Wyoming, right? Mm-hmm. So it's, if it's in the, a little trade-off there.
Yeah, so I mean the DDA will take care of those expenses within the DDA district.
Right.
So, and otherwise some of those expenses would be borne by the city.
Yeah, so it's a trade-off there. That's my main question.
That's it? Any more questions on the DDA budget? How about the capital improvement plan? Any questions on that?
My concern was, I think my fellow councilman answered this for me, but just wanted, like 2028, let's say we have the economy is just tanked and we're just, our country is state suffering, our city suffering. I won't be here, but with 2028 council members have the option to say, well, let's delay this, or?
Yeah, absolutely. Okay. They with each of these projects, and you know, we're making a projection 5 years in the future of what projects we'll need and what those costs will be and how we'll pay for them. So, and we update this every year. And the idea is to plan for this and set aside money for these projects so that when that time comes, we can do them. But for each of these projects, we still would be bringing these before the City Council for approval. And so if we had a financial emergency, to use your example, then it's likely that, you know, some of these projects we may hold off doing, you know, until that financial emergency passes.
Okay.
That answers your question.
Yeah, thanks, John. Thanks, Mr. Mayor.
Yeah, I think, you know, the confusion there for me originally was, and maybe it is still for some, is the rest of these are all 24, 25, 24, 25, and that one's 24 to 29 because of the way we set it up. So, but it doesn't mean we're approving to spend dollars now that we're going to spend in three years.
Correct.
Now, when we review it next year for next year's budget, will it be a capital improvement plan then for 2025 to 2030 then?
Yep.
Okay.
Yep. And we're actually, I believe, looking at making it a six-year plan to comply with our good friends at GASB, Governmental Accounting Standards Board. They really want to see 6 years. So you'll actually probably see a six-year plan, but it will be updated. And sometimes over those times, priorities can change. You know, so certain projects could be moved up or moved back.
Okay.
But this is not a commitment. There's no obligation. This doesn't obligate the city to spend all of this money on all these projects. Each of these projects would have to come before the council.
Okay. Questions on that, or any questions on biosolids or fee schedule? Any questions on the general city budget or any of these? If not,
you know, I do have a question. I think it's under the fee schedule. We have to pay to play tennis or basketball in the parks? Because that's, I think I saw that under the fee schedule. Even though we're a resident,
I don't know.
Like rent tennis, the tennis court or the basketball court.
Is that if a school is renting it or something, maybe? Or
it's usually renting it for a group, not for an individual resident, just to go play
tennis. School
tennis
team?
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, because that one kind of shocked me. Yeah.
So if they have a group that wants to kind of take control of a court for 2 hours or something like that and have exclusive use of that court.
Then they can rent it for that particular
But if someone just shows up and wants to just play, you know, resident, then they can just do that.
Okay.
I know, Renee, some of the private schools, you know, have who don't have their own fields and such have rented our parks, ball diamonds and fields and courts for many years.
Yeah.
The city's been very helpful to them to, you know, so they can have a home field.
Yeah,
you know,
which is good.
Instead of building it themselves.
Yeah.
So any other questions on D through H?
Well, I do have a, I don't know. The hawk thing with the hawk signal thing, was that under one of these?
No, that we were just simply setting a public hearing for the next meeting on that.
Okay, gotcha.
Yep.
Beautiful.
Okay, let's call the roll.
Councilmember Arnoyes?
Yes.
DeKreiger?
Yes.
Brand?
Yes.
Hill?
Yes.
Postema?
Yes.
Hostler?
Yes.
Mayor?
Yes. Good to have that behind us. We've been working on that for quite a while. Little break until next spring, right? 16, award of bids, contracts, purchases, and renewal of bids and contracts. Let's do letter I, please.
Resolution I is approving and authorizing signing, payment for, and recording of third transmission main project easement documents.
Motion, Postma, support by Postler. Mr. Shea, anything we need to know before we vote?
Just again, I referred to this earlier in the meeting, but these are for temporary construction easements, water transmission main easements, and settlement agreements for crop damage for, I think it's 9 different parcels of property.
Okay. Questions? Call the roll.
Councilmember Postma?
Yes.
Hostler?
Yes.
Arnoyes?
Yes.
Brand?
Yes.
DeKreiger?
Yes.
Hill?
Yes.
Mayor?
Yes. Letter J, please.
Resolution J is to approve final payment for the Michigan Department of Transportation for the construction of a non-motorized trail and the reconstruction of Plaster Creek Boulevard from Division Avenue to Buchanan Avenue. This resolution includes budget amendment number 52.
Motion, please. Motion by DeKreiger, support by Postler. Mr. Shea.
So back in 2022, we entered into an agreement with MDOT to reconstruct Plaster Creek Boulevard between Buchanan and Division, and also to construct a non-motorized trail. We received some grant funding from MDOT for that trail. And so MDOT did the final accounting of that project and determined that our local share, because we owed 36% on the non-motorized trail and 100% on the road project. And so when they did their final accounting of the expenses, our actual expenses were about $65,000 higher than what MDOT estimated at the outset of the project.
Questions? Call the roll.
Councilmember DeKreiger?
Yes.
Hostler?
Yes.
Arnoyes?
Yes.
Brand?
Yes.
Hill?
Yes.
Postman?
Yes.
Mayor?
Yes. Letter K, please.
Resolution K is to accept a proposal for an environmental site assessment at Fisher Avenue and to authorize the mayor and city clerk to execute the contract.
Motion, please. DeKreiger, support by Hill.
So we have a gravel, Fisher Avenue is actually a gravel road. It's just east of Clay and south of 54th. And it's caused a lot of maintenance, and we've had some significant flooding issues there. So we plan to install a storm sewer and also install sanitary and water main. Because of the historical uses of the nearby properties, we're concerned that the soil or groundwater may be contaminated. So we want to enter into a contract with, missing the name here for a second, Dixon, thank you, to do an environmental site assessment for about $11,500 with a $5,000 contingency in case they find additional things under the ground.
Questions? I did not know where that street was, and I've lived in Wyoming for over 25 years. John had to look it up on the county map in his office the other day. So let's call the roll.
Councilmember DeKreiger?
Yes.
Hill?
Yes.
Arnoyes?
Yes.
Brand?
Yes.
Postema?
Yes.
Hostler?
Yes.
Mayor?
Yes. Letter L, please.
Resolution L is to accept a proposal for replacement of an irrigation system on Clyde Park Avenue Southwest.
Motion. Motion by Postma, support by Postler.
So if council recalls, we're repaving Clyde Park between 36th and 44th. And I don't want to say as part of that project, but at the same time as that project, we would like to replace the irrigation system in the boulevard there. It's over 30 years old. It covers 14 different medians. We did go out for bid, and we're recommending acceptance of the low bid from Winchell Irrigation for just over $94,000.
Okay. Any questions?
Can I put out a radical idea? Can we just let it go brown and just put wood chips in it?
In the median?
Yeah.
I mean, all medians.
Well, let's do one at a time. That's a lot of money.
That's a question for Myra.
I know. Because half the time they water the road anyway, so they'll get your car wet. But that's a lot to maintain. But I just wanted to throw that idea out there.
At the end of the day, it's up to council, but I and it's maybe personal preference, but just the green grass boulevards tend to soften kind of the concrete jungle that can be out there with obviously all of the roads that we have. So
we have residents asking us to plant flowers too, which is a step in the greener direction instead of the less green direction. So I feel like that would be a bummer to the residents who appreciate, I guess, just having it look like a nice place when they drive by.
We require citizens to put in irrigation in commercial property, so I think it'd be a hard sell to not water our own lawn. That's just my thought.
Mr. Brand?
I know we tried something on Buchanan. It was like it wasn't grass. It was like a putting green, and it was a terrible mistake, and it didn't work. So
when did we do that?
It was near my restaurant, and it was just a small part. That was a long time ago. So I do think the grass does make our city look a little softer.
What, you do a little research on that and have a conversation with Myra, see where it goes.
Okay, yeah.
Okay.
Also, one thing, Ms. Mayor, yep. I saw also wood chips. I know when I've done them at my restaurant, if you don't do it right, I mean, I know a city would do it right, but weeds just grow through those wood chips. So they're not always answer either. So.
Thanks for that. Well, let's call a roll on this.
Councilmember Postma?
Yes.
Postler?
Yes.
Arnoitz?
Yes.
Brand?
Yes.
DeKreiger?
Yes.
Hill?
No.
Mayor?
Yes. Let's take N, O, and P together, please.
We got to do M first.
Take M first.
Okay. Resolution M is to accept an amendment for the Water System Reliability Study and Asset Management Plan.
Motion, please. Motion by Arnoitz, support by DeKreiger. I got ahead of myself there. I crossed that one off before we got to it.
So we want to do some updates to our GIS system, especially as it relates to our water system. And basically, hopefully I'm not getting too technical, but we're trying to correct some inaccuracies in the GIS system with our water system and make it easier to use while retaining our historical repair data on water mains and valves and so forth. So we want to enter into a contract with Prine and Newhoff to do that. We used to have engineering interns do this. We haven't been able to get interns for the last couple of years. And from what Myron has indicated, sometimes the quality of the work in that was not up to snuff as well. So we'd like to have Prine and Newhoff update at least the water side of our GIS system.
Questions? Call the roll.
Councilmember Arnoitz?
Yes.
DeKreiger?
Yes.
Brand?
Yes.
Hill?
Yes.
Postma?
Yes.
Postler?
Yes.
Mayor?
Yes. Now we'll do N, O, and P together, please.
Resolution N is to accept a proposal for cleaning and disinfecting services. Resolution O is to approve payment of annual fees for renewal of computer hardware and software license and maintenance agreements. And Resolution P is for award of bid for Gazan Pump Station HVAC improvements.
Motion, please. Motion by Postler, support by Postma.
So the first one would be a request to renew with Paul Davis. They do our, if a resident suffers a sewer backup, we have Paul Davis come in and do the cleanup and restoration work at the house. They work really well with our residents during a pretty emotional, take it from someone that's had to deal with a lot of sewer backup claims in my career. They really work well with the residents in a very emotional time. The annual renewal of our computer hardware and software license and maintenance agreements. So that's basically all of the software that we use, and we do budget for this, but that's about a $1.2 million renewal of all of those agreements. And then our Gazan pump station, some of the HVAC equipment goes back to the 1960s. I think our boiler goes back to 1964. And we're recommending to replace and update our HVAC system for about $128,000 plus a 5% contingency.
Okay. Questions? None? Let's call the roll.
Councilmember Postler?
Yes.
Postema?
Yes.
Arnoyes?
Yes.
Brand?
Yes.
DeKreiger?
Yes.
Hill?
Yes.
Mayor?
Yes. No ordinances tonight. Any informational material, Mr. Shea?
Nope.
None. Okay. Acknowledgement of visitors. This public comment period is an opportunity to share concerns or present topics to the City Council that were not part of the meeting's agenda. This is not an opportunity for dialogue, but Council may make referrals or request staff to follow up with you. Please provide your name and address when approaching the podium. There's a 3-minute limit per person. Who would like to come up and speak first? Public comment. Here's your chance. Seeing none, we'll go around the council, starting with Mr. Postman. Mr. Brand.
Sure. I went to a Public Works event today, and it was well attended. I saw John there and Patrick, but I asked the snowplow person that was had a, what how many miles per gallon he got, and he said 1 mile per gallon for our snow plows. So so sometimes, and I think we have the best snow plows in the state. I mean, they help first responders. Our streets are really clear. I think we do a fantastic job, and as a small business owner, I recognize that too. But sometimes citizens ask, you know, why taxes? Why? But there's one reason: one gallon, 1 mile per gallon. So to keep our streets clean, which is worth it. So thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Tommy. Marissa.
Yeah, just actually, I had another thought of regarding the medians. Have we ever considered, instead of like maintaining grass, which requires, you know, the manpower to cut the grass and all that, just dropping a bunch of wildflower seeds for like native plants and sort of letting it be, I don't know, just sort of wild and nature-y, so it's still green and, you know, alive, but without as much maintenance, or?
Like a little wildflower garden down the middle of the road.
Yeah.
We have actually looked into that, not at, in medians, but at the clean water plant. We looked into it, and it turned out that it was a project idea of mine, actually. I wanted to plant sunflowers in a big vacant field that we have where we used to have some infrastructure. And it turned out that it isn't just like plant and forget and then enjoy, you know, nature's bounty. It turned out there was a lot of work behind it, and we ended up deciding that we just didn't have the ability to care for it and tend it and husband it the way it needs to be done. So we haven't looked into it in for medians, but it certainly is something that we could take a look at.
Just throwing it out there. That's all.
Okay. Mr. Arnold.
Nothing.
Mr. DeKreiger.
Just would like to thank everybody that showed up tonight. Excuse me. We have a lot of staff here, residents. Love it that our firemen are here. And for those of you who may not know, we have a celebrity fireman here today, too. He was actually our fireman of the year. So that guy right back there in the gray shirt, Brad. So make sure you, he's trying not to get attention, but sorry, Brad. But I know our firemen, they come when we vote on budgets, and love to see you guys here. We support your work. We love what you do in our city. And just thank you for all that you do. Thank you for supporting us. And I know there's some new hires in here, so we're going to ask you to get busy and get some more firemen for us. and just appreciate what you do. And same with you, Chief Coster, and your people just are really appreciative of what we have in our city for safety. I think that's it for me.
Yeah, the Public Works was a blast. I went later and didn't see anybody, but had a riot, and just love those folks, and they do a great job. It was very fun. Put my grandkids in the back seat of the police car. Took pictures. That was fun. And, and David Barton came and spoke at church yesterday, and he's just such a phenomenal, and it just gives us real purpose for what we do at the local level. We have a great influence at the local level, and I just feel that we are kind of gatekeepers to the safety of our city and what goes on here, and to be an element of good, and kind of make sure that we are up and up, and we have a big responsibility to our city. And I love Marissa's idea about the wildflowers on the meetings. I like that idea. Yeah. We need to talk more about that. So.
Thank you. Yeah, local government's where it's at, you know. Many of us have been involved, or some have been involved in other levels of government and such, but I think local government's great because that's where it really starts, you know. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, the Public Works Open House, again, thank you for doing it, Myron. I was not able to attend this year. I had a meeting up on the north end of town at 5 o'clock, and I zipped back here, and I navigated 131 South. So, interesting, huh? So a couple events coming up. Memorial Day ceremony. We will have a guest speaker again this year, and it's a very good friend of mine, a good friend of the city of Wyoming, and he spoke before, and that's Lieutenant Colonel Denny Gillum. He will do a great job. It will also include performance by the Godfrey Lee High School Band and a salute from our police department and fire department honor guard. So there we go. Veterans Memorial Garden, 7 o'clock Monday. Kellogg'sville Park reopening will be Wednesday, June 5. Grand opening to celebrate park's new equipment. This event will include activities from Challenge Island 616 West. It's interesting. Okay, I don't know what that is, but I'm going to find out. Snacks and refreshments will be provided in locations Kellogg'sville Park. And concerts in the park will begin on June 18. They'll go through July 30. There will be 6 concerts total, beginning at 6 o'clock p.m. on Tuesday nights. And again, that location is Lamar Park. So with that, meeting adjourned.